So, needless to say, the DNC is in pretty bad shape right now, and this is because they have no real message, and as a result, they're not able to appeal to voters, and they can't win elections. And worse for them is that they even have a large portion of their own base that just outright hates them. Progressives. And this is because they want nothing to do with progressives. In fact, they voted down a ban on lobbyist contributions to the DNC because they thought that they would be more successful at raising money and catering to their large multinational corporation and billionaire donors than actual progressives. And also, we hate them because they rigged the primary in 2016. So there's a ton of reasons why the DNC is in bad shape right now. Almost all of it is self-inflicted. All of it is self-inflicted, let me be clear. And they're just an embarrassment. But it gets even worse for the DNC because, unlike what they expected, there's another portion of the population that is now jumping ship. They're large billionaire donors and multinational corporations. So according to The Hill, they report that months of post-election malaise hamstrung the Democratic National Committee's fundraising over the first 6 months of 2017, creating a serious money gap with Republicans and raising questions about Democrats' ability to take advantage of opportunities in the 2018 midterm elections. The DNC raised $38.2 million in the first half of the year, compared with the Republican National Committee's $75.4 million haul during that period, a $37.2 million difference. As of June 30th, the RNC has almost $45 million in the bank, while the DNC has just under $7.5 million along with $3 million in debt. Many Democrats are frustrated by the sluggish fundraising pace, which comes even as President Trump's sagging approval rating drives Democratic outrage across the country. Perez noted that the party is still in the process of staffing up in a statement to The Hill. At the DNC, we are still building up our team, including hiring fundraising staff and making sure every aspect of our organization is moving in lockstep, he said. We're confident that our team will raise the resources needed as we head into 2018 and beyond. It's deeply problematic, and it's because our party leadership has to be dragged kicking and screaming by the base to lead an opposition, Democratic strategist Christy Setzer said, urging Democrats to ramp up the pressure on Trump. After a full court press meant to raise hundreds of millions for Hillary Clinton's campaign and allied groups, an effort most Democrats expected would end with her in the White House, major donors admit that they are tired. So, this is incredibly embarrassing for the Democratic Party, and it's especially embarrassing for the new DNC chair, Tom Perez. And in fact, if he doesn't turn this around soon, I wouldn't be surprised if the Democratic Party's biggest donors who are sticking with them and some party insiders don't start calling for his resignation, because you just can't keep having bad fundraising months over and over and over. He's proving to be an incompetent leader. Now, one thing that's clear to me after reading this article is that they still don't really know why they can't raise any money. To the strategist who thinks that the Democratic Party needs to focus more on Trump, you're not a strategist. You need to quit your job and go into some other sector, because that's one of the most clueless statements I've ever heard a strategist make.
You are really dumb, for real.
They are exclusively focusing on Trump. One of the messages they floated for their new slogan was, vote Democrats 2018. Well, because look at the other guys. I mean, are you kidding me right now? They stand for nothing. They don't have a message, and because they thought that they could raise enough money exclusively through their billionaire corporate donors, well, the base now knows that they're not looking out for them, and they're not going to give you any money. But Tom Perez knows that he's got to turn this around if he wants to keep his job, so, I mean, he's starting to get really desperate, and it's starting to show. So, according to The Hill, President Obama will be reemerging on the political scene this fall, and, quote, he is likely to take on fundraising, for example, something he has done for the Democratic National Committee and the National Democratic Redistricting Committee since leaving office. So, they're so desperate that they're trying to force a former president out of retirement so that way he can beg for donations to his billionaire donors, presumably, because he certainly delivered. And since he has rapport with those rich people, you know, they think that he can be successful and boost their fundraising efforts. How pathetic. That's just one of the most pathetic things ever. But if you thought that that was the most pathetic aspect of their desperation, it gets worse, because the DNC literally sent out these scary-looking letters, presumably to trick people into opening them out of fear that an overdue bill would be headed to collections. This is real. And on that envelope, it claimed to have come from the finance department, and it reads final notice in gigantic, scary letters, but in smaller letters at the top, it's clear there that it came from the Democratic National Committee. So they have no shame whatsoever. No shame. Tom Perez should resign just based on this, because what they were trying to do with that final notice was they wanted to strike fear into the hearts of people who received that letter and get them to actually open it. It's such a shady tactic that they use to manipulate people. And look, if you're a poor person, if you've struggled to pay your bills, by seeing those words final notice, even though they put Democratic National Committee on there just for some plausible deniability, that will strike fear into the hearts of anyone who struggled to pay their bills, to pay their mortgage, to pay for water and electricity. And that's all they're going to see. They're just going to open the bill, or what looks like a bill, frantically. And it's so pathetic. It's so disgusting that they would exploit the fears that poor people have that already are struggling to pay their bills and making them think that they're overdue. What a disgusting tactic. The DNC should be absolutely ashamed of themselves for doing this. I mean, who greenlit this? Whoever did needs to just resign. That's a shame. That's a new low. I mean, they've shown us that they are willing to stoop to any level to get money. But you idiots wouldn't have had to do this. You wouldn't have had so much trouble fundraising if you didn't choose to abandon your base for your corporate donors. If you recall, back when Tom Perez was first elected as the DNC chair back in February, they immediately rejected a ban on lobbyist contributions. So what that told us was that you don't want anything to do with us. You don't want our money because your corporate donors are going to take care of you. And now that your corporate donors are not taking care of you because you are incompetent and you can't win, now, since we still won't give you money, you're trying to scare us and trick us into giving you money. It's absolutely unacceptable. So look, you don't get to have it both ways. Either you stop asking us for money and stop trying to trick your voters into giving you money, or you swear off all your billionaire and multinational corporation donors or give back the money that you took from them. You have chosen time and again, and you've really reiterated this in your actions, that you don't want anything to do with ordinary people. So you should be ashamed of yourself that you would even ask them for money. And you should be even more ashamed of yourself that you're willing to trick them and get them to be afraid that maybe they missed one of their bills and it was going to be headed to collections. I mean, shame on you. It's just despicable.
Support this podcast by becoming a patron at patreon.com/humanistreport.